Friends, it's me again to continue my last class on cell biology. That means the discussion on cell viability study by trypan and Bluestein. In my last class, that is the phase one class, we have prepared the trypan and Bluestein and the phosphate buffer of different stain. In this phase, we will use them in the cell suspension staining and the counting of the cells process. First of all, let us make the cell suspension from the test sample. Our test sample is a live rat, and we have to collect the peritoneal fluid from the body of the rat by syringe. First of all, take the drainable syringe and take PBS of 1 x strength in that syringe. At least 5 ml in capacity. Now inject this PBS solution in 2 ml quantity at least into the peritoneal cavity of the body of the rat. Now massage this cavity. We space for 5 minutes for cellular release inside. Now draw out this fluid. After 5 minutes, at least 1 ml in quantity in the peritoneal fluid should be drawn out by 5 ml syringe. And after that, pour that fluid inside the PBS solution, which was kept previously in a beaker. It is done for the preservation of this peritoneal fluid preserved in PBS. Now let us centrifuge it. Take 1 ml of the cell suspension from this beaker is taken from the stock solution and in a centrifuge tube, and centrifuge it at the inside the centrifuge machine at 1000 rpm for 5 minutes at room temperature. After 5 minutes, you will find this a supernatant and a pellet. This supernatant liquid should be discarded and from the tube, and the pellet will be resuspended again with the PBS solution again. Now this resuspended cells will be used for the ready and will be used for the staining section. Now come to the staining process. So, our second step is to stain those cells suspended in the sample. First, hold by hand or keep it in the vortex machine to swirl the container so that the cells are evenly distributed. Then, take out 100 μL, that is 0.1 ml of cell suspension using a P2000 Gilson pipette and keep it in the phase FN trough. Now mix it with 100 μL, that is 0.1 ml from 0.4% freshly prepared working solution of trypan blue at 1:1 ratio, and vertex it in the mixer for mixing for a while. Then incubate it for 5 minutes in a room temperature. Okay, now look at what happens in this incubation period. These are events occur during this period. Cells in the live condition selectively refuse to enter the stain at 960 Dalton molecules of the stain particles are impermeable to alive cell membrane, as well as the trypan blue is negatively charged, so they do not interact until the cell membrane is damaged. But the stain are cytotoxic, so after 5 minutes it starts to kill the cell. When cell dies by apoptosis, membrane's integrity is lost and shrinkage of the membrane occurs, nuclear fragmentation occurs, then the stain enters through the pores of the cell membrane and binds with the intracellular serum protein with azo group, and thus it gives the blue color to the dead cells. So we can see the two types of cells there. One, the stained cell, and another, the unstained cells. Stained cells are dead, and cells are live cells. Dead cells will look like this, swollen, large, dark blue color, and wrinkled outside the cell membrane. But in case of live cell, it is smooth, rounded, reflective, and small in color, safe. Lastly, we have to count these live cells, that is these viable cells, per millimeter in a hemocytometer. Now let us load these cells into the hemocytometer. This is the hemocytometer and the counting chamber of the hemocytometer, and these are the two chambers there covered by the cover sleeve. Here are four ridges along the counting chamber and two groups. You have to clean this instrument, that means the cover with the cover sleeve and the instrument, by alcohol. Now take 10 ml of the trypan blue treated cell suspension from the ephedra tube, and after shaking it will be collected by a micropipette. Now fill the chambers with this micropipette with the micropipette at the chamber under the cover sleeve. Under the cover sleeve, it will go inside by capillary action. Now focus the grid line, that the scaling of the swelling of the chamber with 10x objective, and find the floating cells under the chamber. Now let us count the cell. Here, this is the chamber you will find under the objective, 10x objective, and these are the four cornered cell which has been marked A, B, C, D, and you will also see the four corner chambers, stained and unstained cells. Your purpose is to count in every 16 set of cells here and record it in the table, unstained and stained separately. And these cells, for the A, B, C, D, you will get the average cells, and adding the two cells, you will get the total number of cells. Now let us calculate the cells in percentage and get our next result. For calculation, we have a formula: the total percentage of viable cells per milliliter will be found when the total number of viable cells will be multiplied by 100, will be divided by the total number of cells, both types, stained and unstained. Coming out from the result of a table, we get the unstained viable cells are 18.5, total cell is 22. So the number of viable cells, 18.5 per millimeter cube in hemocytometer, will be converted to cells per milliliter by multiplying it 10^4. Thus we get 185,000 per milliliter. Like that, total cells we get 220,000 per milliliter. Hence, putting this value into the same formula, we get the result 84.09. Hence, we can say, so viable cell present in per millimeter is diluted cell, suspension is 84.09. To get into the undiluted cell concentration, we have to multiply this result with the dilution factor. Even the viability of the cell is subject to change if the suspension is treated for a long time with trypan blue. Okay, then this is all for my today's class. In the next phase, that is phase 2 of the same topic. Then if you like my class, then share and subscribe my channel, and meet you in the next class to discuss on another topic. Thank you very much.